Byron Kennedy and I decided to make a feature film. Now, I thought if you're really prepared, you could, the film automatically would follow. Well, I was in for a big surprise because it just didn't go anywhere where it needed to go. It described it like walking a really big dog. You want it to go that way and it drags you this way. And it was bewildering to me. Then the best and the worst things happened. We ran out of money in post-production. So Byron cut the sound. He was my produced with me, and I cut the picture. I had 9 months, close to a year in all, but I had to drop it now and then, confronting, myself in the kitchen where we were cutting, all the mistakes I made. And it was a really great lesson because I thought, I should have done that, I should have done this. And luckily, when the film came together, it did work. I mean, suddenly it gets shown in Japan and France and all around the world, and people saw something in it. I think it was because we had tapped into some archetype, which I was completely unaware of at that point. So when the opportunity came up to do a second one, I was able to do all the things that I had learnt from that experience. So the second film, I think very perceptive actually, was quite a big shift, both in the themes of the story and in the techniques. And in fact, the first movie was really, for me, a very brutal experience in terms of creativity. I really thought I wasn't cut out to make movies. And then the second movie, even though it was much more physically demanding, we had more budget, but for complexity of reasons, we didn't have a lot of time. And the second film was shot in continuity, because the story allowed you to do that. So basically, we ran out of screenplay at one point, and for one day we didn't shoot while I figured out with Terry Hayes what we should do next. But I knew by then that that's filmmaking, that things are always going to go wrong, and you have to ride that big dog in some way, to get it done.